Lawmakers in Washington, D.C. are debating changes to the nation's farm bill. Every few years, Congress passes a new farm bill that sets policies for the next several years. Last year, lawmakers extended the farm bill from 2008 for another year to allow time for lawmakers to focus on executive changes in the next farm bill. This will affect farmers here in Mahaska County. The U.S. Senate recently approved their version of the bill, and the U.S. House is expected to work on its version yet this month. Some say a new farm bill could be in place by Labor Day. Aaron Riggs explains what one expected change will mean for local farmers and the economy.
A farm bill has been around since the 1930s. It mandates spending by the U.S. Department of Agriculture, which goes toward various food programs like food stamps, as well as providing subsidies to farmers.
So that they all have an opportunity to meet that mission of an abundant, inexpensive, safe, wholesome food supply.
And to achieve that mission, farmers have to continually supply food on a yearly basis. But if a farmer can't turn a profit, or at least break even from his expenses, farms could go out of business. That could reduce the food supply and make food more expensive. The government prevents that from happening, however, by providing subsidies.
It assures that in the bad years, that farmers will be able to survive.
The banks said either get in the farm program or get out of farming.
Steve Boonder joined the farm program in the 1980s and has received government subsidies totaling almost $560,000 since 1995. A little more than $218,000 of that in the form of what's called a direct payment. Direct payments are payments made to farmers based on the historic production of a given plot of land. It's used to help offset production costs, allowing farmers to still turn a profit during tough times. But even during good times with record-setting prices, farmers still receive a direct payment. A reason why both House and Senate lawmakers will cut direct payments from the farm bill. Last year, Boonder received about $16,000 in direct payments.
Definitely a significant portion.
But says he doesn't need it anymore.
Currently, crop prices are more profitable.
Meaning Boonder has relied more on the sale of his crops recently and not the direct payments. Ending direct payments is expected to save the government $5 billion in spending, something Boonder appreciates.
I think the government should try as hard as they can to cut spending. I'm willing to do my $15,000-$16,000 a year to make that happen.
However, farmers aren't the only ones who've benefited from direct payments.
Direct payments are really transfer payments into our economy. These are dollars that are earned somewhere else, California, New York, Texas, wherever, and they're given back, or they're given to an Iowa farmer.
Wells says that for every $1,000 that comes into the county as a direct payment, it's likely to go through the economy 3.5 times, making it worth about $3,500 in economic benefit.
This creates employment, this creates goods and services, it creates sales taxes.
Since 1995, the amount of direct payments made to farmers in Mahaska County have totaled almost $47 million. Last year, Mahaska farmers received $3.8 million in direct payments. Cutting the program has both pros and cons.
The plus is we don't spend that from a federal government standpoint. The negative is we don't get that transfer payment into the economy of Mahaska County.
Even without direct payments, farmers will still receive some help from the government. That will be in the form of subsidies for crop revenue insurance. Currently, the government pays about 62% of the crop insurance premiums.
So the safety net is now based on our insurance, which I think is a good way of doing it.
Ensuring that U.S. residents can continue to afford one of life's necessities. For CRI Weekly News, I'm Aaron Riggs.
A new farm bill is expected to be cut more than $24 billion from the USDA's $146 billion budget. The majority of those cuts, nutrition assistance programs. Those make up about 75% of the USDA's budget.